why here.
Well, St. Patrick didn't get a great reception here.
Did he not?
No. Around 2 miles up the road there, he was actually attacked by local people, and his charioteer Adrian was martyred.
Oh. Yeah.
But after that, I think the locals sort of adopted the new religion fairly well, with the establishment of St. Rowan's monasteries here and that. Yeah.
That's great. Thanks for the change. Yeah. Right, next up on the programme here is Philomena Begley and I End Over the Hill here on Ireland's Country.
Philomena Begley there, I Ain't Over the Hill. Great song, and of course, Philomena Begley still going as strong as ever.
A fantastic entertainer. She's so well loved by the Irish public and people further afield as well. Next up on the programme, here's the sound of Roslyn and an old maid in the garret here on Ireland's Country.
Will if this be true, I will go without the bid. Oh, kind providence, won't you send me to a wedding? And it's, oh dear me, how would it be if I die an old maid in a garret? Well, there's my sister Kate, she's not handsome or good looking. Scarcely 16 and a fella she was courting. Now 24 with a son and a daughter here in my 45, and I've never had another, and it's, oh dear me, how would it be if I die an old maid in a garret? I can cook and I can sew, I can keep the house right tidy, rise up in the morning and get the breakfast ready. There's nothing in this whole world not so cheery as a weak fat man to call me his own dearie, and it's, oh dear me, how would it be if I die an old maid in a garret? Oh, come Landsman, come Pinsman, come Tinker, come Tailor, come Fiddler, come Dancer, come Cowboy, come Sailor, come Rich Man, come Poor Man, come Fooler, come Witty, come any man at all that will marry me for pity. And it's, oh dear me, how would it be if I die an old maid in a garret? Well, now I'm away home, for nobody's heeding, nobody's bleeding, or any's bleeding. I'm away home to my old baby garret. If I can't get a man, then I'll have to get a parrot. And it's, oh dear me, how would it be if I die an old maid in a garret?
Country is brought to you by enjoytravel.co.uk, music and dancing holidays. Enjoy Travel are delighted to present Pat Jordan and Finian's Rainbow, Spring Fling, in the magnificent Waverley Castle Hotel in Melrose, Scotland, from Friday, March 31st until April 3rd. There's a super lineup of entertainment with Pat Jordan and Finian's Rainbow, Irene and Tom, Nikki James, J&K Country, Joe Boyle, and Glen Shane Country. You can book this wonderful weekend online at enjoytravel.co.uk or by calling 01254 445050.
The Dancing Diary is brought to you by the three-night Easter dancing weekend in the Lady Gregory Hotel, Gort, County Galway, from April 14th to 17th, with music by Cleona Hagen, John McNichol, Robert Mazzell and many more. For more details, phone 091-632333. And here's a look at our Dancing Diary this week. The Woodford Dolman Hotel in Carlow. Thursday, March 9th, dancing to Brendan and Patricia Lee, with DJ Eddie and the Country Sound Disco from 9. Tracy's West County Hotel, Ennis and County Clare, Sunday, March 12th, afternoon dancing to Tommy O'Flaherty from 3 to 6. The Castle Arms Hotel, Durrow, County Leash, Sunday, March 12th, dancing from 3 to 6 to Adrian Ryan and from 8 to 11 with Michael Collins. The Parkview House, Shillelagh, County Wicklow, Saturday, March 11th, dancing to Dull and Dusted from 10. The Creighton Hotel, Clonus, County Monaghan, on Sunday, March 12th, dancing from 10 to Brenda McGee and Eugene Cunningham. This is where you'll see Brenda McGee and Eugene Cunningham this week. Thursday, March 9th, the Castle Court Hotel, Westport, County Mayo. Friday, March 10th, Lorrha GA Complex, Lorrha, County Tipperary. Saturday, March 11th, Baileyborough Community Centre, Baileyborough, County Cavan. And Sunday, March 12th, the Creighton Hotel, Clonus, County Monaghan. And the Ireland's Country Jamboree takes place on Monday, April 3rd in the Tullamore Court Hotel, Tullamore, County Offaly. Joining us for our concert are Patrick Feeney, Gary Gamble as Daniel O'Double, Cleona Hagen, the Honky Tonk Angels, Barry Kerwin, Dave Lawler, Simon Casey, Eddie Carey and Olivia Douglas. Tickets and accommodation packages are available from the Tullamore Court Hotel by phoning 057-934-6666.
So, July's rich and same day dad. August, Lucy's 14. September, 6th birthday, 6th. October, man. November, John and Grant. December's on to Meg and Christmas. January, big month. February, Tinto and our anniversary. And March is now with me.
And now, earn free personalised cards with our new loyalty scheme, Moonpig Rewards.
Moonpig.com.
In the heat of the moment, condoms aren't your first thought. But withdrawal is not an effective way to prevent pregnancy. A study estimated that only 55% of pregnancies in the UK are planned. Visit the Family Planning Association online to get informed about all contraception choices and find one that works for you. This message is supported by Durex.
Only Poof! What did I ever do without you? Shop hundreds of styles, plus free delivery. Buy one, get one free on all boots at justfab.co.uk.
Ireland's Country is brought to you by enjoytravel.co.uk, music and dancing holidays.
Welcome back to part two of Ireland's Country. Well, coming up next is a young lady called Cleona. She's doing very well at the moment, not just on the music, but also on the television, and she's one of the guests who will be taking part in our concert. Here it is, it's called Straight to You, here on Ireland's Country.
Tender heart, and I came straight to you. Well, I do my best to tell the truth. Ask my friends if you need proof. If you don't count my reckless youth, I came straight to you. I thought I walked a twisted trail to a sovereign land or two. Yeah, one foot in front of the other, baby, and I came straight to you.
James, Lorrha is just off the main road between Portumna and Burn. A lot of people don't realise that just a stone's throw off the main road, there's all this history.
Yeah, that's right, Brendan. It's actually a hidden gem here.
Yeah.
Just behind us here, we have the 15th century Augustinian Priory.
Right.
It was built by the local chieftains O'Kendy as well, so it had a tower house over maybe 2 miles over in that direction. I suppose there was a building boom at the time.
Yeah.
So they built the two of them. So, yeah.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
And obviously, what date does it go back
to?
The
15th century. 15th century. The order was here in maybe 12th, 13th century. There's reference to the order here in 12th, 13th century. Yeah.
It's unreal.
Yeah, it's unreal. We have a sort of a link there with America as well over in Minneapolis.
Right.
There was actually what they call a piscina where the holy vessels were washed.
Yes.
And in 1880, a local priest, well, a priest up from English there, actually took the whole piscina out and is actually over in the Church of the Immaculate Conception in Minneapolis.
There you go.
So seemingly there's a little epitaph, not an epitaph, a little sort of plaques saying from the banks of the River Shannon to the banks of the Mississippi, so we'll have to go over there sometime.
Yeah. That's for sure. Yeah. Next up on the programme, here's Hurricane Highway and Keep Them Kisses Coming here on Ireland's Country.
You got your ear down, you got the look in your eye. It says, come here and get me, boy, lay me down, it'll be just right, yeah. Ain't going nowhere, I got a bottle of wine. I got milk in the time of my hands, and I'm gonna be a man tonight. Oh, yes, I am. I can't imagine doing nothing but what I'm doing. All I want to do is get your lips on my girl, you want you.
stop driving me crazy. I swear there's honey on your lips. Baby, give me one more long, slow kiss. I can't imagine doing nothing but what I'm doing. Just stay around, take a look.
Hurricane Highway there, and keep them kisses coming.
And don't forget to follow us on Facebook.com/ Ireland's Country. And we've got a lot of messages in because we're concert on the 3rd of April at the Tullamore Court Hotel. Many people are going to join us for the night, and hopefully we'll get to see you too.
Indeed, it's a Monday night, and so what else would you be doing? Next up on the programme, here's Derek Ryan. It's his latest one. It's one called 60 Years Ago, here on Ireland's Country.
Blessed candle burning, a light's her golden bud, her beads and book of prayers are resting in her hand. He pulled the chair beside her to sit with her a while. She turns her feeble body to give him one last smile. As he held her wedding finger, softly he did say, I remember when you said I do. Seems like yesterday. But he took my name that morning. My heart did overflow. I still feel the way I did 60 years ago. With a damp white cloth, he suits her. His soul made his best friend. Her suffering now is over. He knows this is the end. And she said they're here to take me. It's time to say goodbye. One last breath, a gentle. He falls from his eyes as he held her wedding finger. Softly he did say, I remember when you said I do. Seems like yesterday when you took my name. Heart overflow, and I still feel the way I did 60 years ago. As he held her wedding finger, softly he said, I remember when you said I. Seems like yesterday when you took my name that morning. My heart did overflow, and I still feel the way I did.
way I could 60 years ago.
Ireland's Country is brought to you by enjoytravel.co.uk, music and dancing holidays. Enjoy Travel are delighted to present Pat Jordan and Finian's Rainbow, Spring Fling, in the magnificent Waverley Castle Hotel in Melrose, Scotland, from Friday, March 31st until April 3rd. There's a super lineup of entertainment with Pat Jordan and Finian's Rainbow, Irene and Tom, Nikki James, J&K Country, Joe Boyle, and Ken Shane Country. You can book this wonderful weekend online at enjoytravel.co.uk or by calling 01254 445050. It's the Ireland's Country Jamboree on Monday, April 3rd at the Tullamore Court Hotel, Tullamore, County Offaly. Starring Patrick Feeney, Fiona Hagen, Barry Kerwin, Gary Gamble, Eddie Carey, the Honky Tonk Angels, Simon Casey, Dave Lawler and Olivia Douglas. Doors at 7.15 and the show starts at 8. Tickets available from the hotel now on 057 934 6666. That's the Ireland's Country Jamboree in the Tullamore Court Hotel, Monday, April 3rd in association with Midlands 103.
Damn, fuck it, son.
John, you can't concentrate when you're hungry. Eat a Snickers.
Better?
Better.
You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers, get some nuts.
We're checking all the smoke alarms on the street. Can I take a look at yours?
Sure.
There we go. And, can I just use your loo?
Don't worry. Thanks to Harpic Power Plus, you get 10 times better cleaning than bleach at limescale removal. It's a real power package. Strong, dark, powerful. Not him. Harpic Power Plus. Discover new Harpic Fresh Power, the toy at rim block with essential oils that delivers the power of freshness lasting up to 4 weeks. Harpic Fresh Power.
Fresh.
But wait. It's boot season. Ankle boots, lace-ups, knee-highs and booties. Only boots. What did I ever do without you? Visit justfab.co.uk. Shop hundreds of styles plus free delivery. Buy one, get one free on all boots at justfab.co.uk.
Join our match cooking classes. A fun way to meet new people doing something you love. Match. Join free today.
There's an amazing deal on VT Broadband. You can enjoy a 25% welcome discount. And get a super reliable Wi-Fi connection. Plus, when you're out and about, you can connect for free to over 5 million hotspots that make up the UK's largest Wi-Fi network. It'll cost £24.99 a month on a 12-month contract, and that includes line rental. Plus, you can get a £75 reward card when you sign up online by the 8th of March. Don't miss the 25% welcome discount. Call 0800 334 422 or visit bt.com/deals.
Ireland's Country is brought to you by enjoytravel.co.uk, music and dancing holidays.
Welcome back to part three of Ireland's Country. Now, one of the many artists appearing on our Country Music Jamboree on the 3rd of April in the Tullamore Court Hotel is Dave Lawler, and a video which he actually shot in Tullamore in the distillery there. Great song, it's called Lonely Nights, here on Ireland's Country.
I don't mean to waste your time. I just need someone to talk to, if you don't mind. Well, I've hung alone in there, but tonight I guess I'm just too weak to fight. I can take the lonely days, but I can't take these lonely nights. Are you me what's your name. I just need someone to lean on. I'm not playing any game. So sit down here beside me and let me buy you a glass of red rose wine. I can take a lonely day, but I can't take these lonely nights. Well, I know that I have a score, but the nights can be so lonely when you need a friend. Ah, but maybe we can find a little peace of mind before the morning comes. Me. If it seems I'm holding on, letting go just ain't easy when you're sleeping alone. So let's forget about tomorrow.
Now, James, we've moved to another site here, and can you tell us the significance of the building here behind us?
Yeah, this is a 10th century church here. It's built on the site of St. Ryan's Timber Church.
Right.
Yeah, there was three phases of building this, the 10th century, and then there was modifications again in the 13th century, again in the 15th century. So there's a lot of history attached to this church. Actually, interestingly enough, this church from 550 AD right up to present time has been continual worship on this site.
Yeah.
And just behind you there, we have the two high crosses as well. This high cross here is said to commemorate St. Ryan, the painter and saint of Lorrha. And across the graveyard is another high cross said to commemorate King Congal, who was a warrior king who actually died here in Lorrha.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Obviously, they were destroyed in Cromwellian times.
Yeah, destroyed in Cromwellian times, yeah. Which is a pity because the high cross over there, there's lovely little figures, there's processions of horses around the perimeter of the base.
Yeah.
There's also a scene of Daniel in the lion's den.
Oh, right, okay.
These crosses would have been brightly coloured with blue, red, orange and yellow. Like, I suppose at the time a lot of people couldn't read or write.
Yes.
So there was actually depictions of scenes from the Bible that people could actually follow the story of the Bible and that.
And there was somebody from royal extraction too met his doom here?
Yeah, there was actually, what was his name, Kinajic, and his son were actually slain, or actually dragged from the altar and killed outside the side of the church here. The main entrance of the church was on that side wall there.
Oh, okay.
So later on in the 12th, 13th century, a new doorway was inserted.
Okay.
This church itself actually would have been all whitewashed, so it would have stood out in the background.
Yes.
And everything. And the structure of the church itself was said to mimic a timber church.
Well, okay.
So there's sort of, you see the antennas at the side of the church?
Yes.
Mimic the timbers coming out from the side of the original timber churches. And with the steep roof and everything to allow rain to fall down.
Thanks to DJs for that. And now on Ireland's Country, here's Ray Lynham and Back in Love by Monday.
We can call Mrs. Johnson, keep the kids a day or two. Take the early flight to London, like the way we used to do. Have room service, bring us breakfast, make love all through the day. We'll
we're not back in love on Monday. We can go our separate ways. If we're not back in love on Monday, we can't say we didn't try. Find that little cafe with the funny sounding man. Get the table by the window. I'll say I love you once again. And if the violin player is still there, we'll dance until break. We're not back in love on Monday. We can go our separate ways. We're not back in love on Monday. We can't say we didn't try. But before we bury our love, let's make sure we let it die. Just take a few more nights together. Say the things we used to say. We're not back in love on Monday. We can go our separate ways.
Ray Island there in a song called Back in Love by Monday. Well, as you know, we're in Lorrha here in North Tipperary, and one of its favourite songs is standing here beside me, a guy called Sean Mannion. Sean, it's great to have you in Ireland's country.
Thank you, Brendan, and it's great to have you here again.
And it's a wonderful area. We found out an awful lot today from James Heenan about the history of the area, but also North Tipperary steeped in music and dancing as well. And you're doing your bit here in Lorrha to promote dancing and social dancing especially.
Yes, we are. We do have social dancing here every Friday night of the year, except Good Friday night. We take a little break on that night. But every other Friday night of the year, we run a social dancing venue here for the, all the local people and for the benefit of the GAA Club.
Yeah, because obviously it takes place here in the complex.
It does, yeah, just behind my back.
And you have social dancing bands from all over the country coming here.
All over the country, from West Cork to Enniskillen, far side of Enniskillen, from Waterford up into Galway, and we get patrons from as far.
That's unreal, isn't it?
It is unreal.
But I know, because myself and Eugene Cunningham geek for you as well, and it's a lovely, you get such a great welcome here in Lorrha, and we always look forward to coming here as well.
Yes, we try and keep it on the old house dance scene. We try and keep it personal and make everyone welcome, even you, Brent.
Listen, thanks for having us here today and for arranging the history lesson with James Heenan as well. It's much appreciated. Now, the video we're going to have next is one of your favourite singers, Muriel O'Connor.
Oh, well, lovely.
That's Muriel O'Connor and Fran Corrie. It's one called Wine Into Water here on Ireland's Country.
Multitude of prayers in my behalf, and I pray one more is not too much to ask. I've tried to fight this battle by myself, but it's a war that I can't win without your help. Tonight I was alone. Has anyone
Now on my knees I'm turning to you, Father. Could you help me turn the wine back into water?
So many times I've hoped the ones I love, push them to the edge of giving up. They've stood by me, but how much can they stand? If I don't put this bottle in your hand.
By enjoytravel.co.uk, music and dancing holidays. It's the Ireland's Country Jamboree on Monday, April 3rd at the Tullamore Court Hotel, Tullamore, County Offaly. Starring Patrick Feeney, Fiona Hagen, Barry Kerwin, Gary Gamble, Eddie Carey, the Honky Tonk Angels, Simon Casey, Dave Lawler, and Olivia Douglas. Doors at 7:15 and the show starts at 8. Tickets available from the hotel now on 057-934-6666. That's the Ireland's Country Jamboree in the Tullamore Court Hotel, Monday, April 3rd, in association with Midlands 103.
The Dancing Diary is brought to you by the three-night Easter Dancing Weekend in the Lady Gregory Hotel, Gort, County Galway, from April 14th to 17th, with music by Cleona Hagen, John McNichol, Robert Mazzell and Manny Moore. For more details, phone 091-632333. And here's a look at our Dancing Diary this week. The Woodford Dolman Hotel in Carlow. Thursday, March 9th, dancing to Brendan and Patricia Lee with DJ Eddie and the Country Sound Disco from 9. Tracy's West County Hotel, Ennis and County Clare, Sunday, March 12th, afternoon dancing to Tommy O'Flaherty from 3 to 6. The Castle Arms Hotel, Durrow, County Leash, Sunday, March 12th, dancing from 3 to 6 to Adrian Ryan and from 8 to 11 with Michael Collins. The Parkview House, Shillelagh, County Wicklow, Saturday, March 11th, dancing to Dull and Dusted from 10. The Creighton Hotel, Clonus, County Monaghan, on Sunday, March 12th, dancing from 10 to Brenda McGee and Eugene Cunningham. This is where you'll see Brenda McGee and Eugene Cunningham this week, Thursday, March 9th, the Castle Court Hotel, Westport, County Mayo. Friday, March 10th, Lorrha GAA Complex, Lorrha, County Tipperary. Saturday, March 11th, Bailyborough Community Centre, Bailyborough, County Cavan. And Sunday, March 12th, the Creighton Hotel, Clonus, County Monaghan. And the Ireland's Country Jamboree takes place on Monday, April 3rd in the Tullamore Court Hotel, Tullamore, County Offaly. Joining us for our concert are Patrick Feeney, Gary Gamble as Daniel O'Double, Cleona Hagen, the Honky Tonk Angels, Barry Kerwin, Dave Lawler, Simon Casey, Eddie Carey and Olivia Douglas. Tickets and accommodation packages are available from the Tullamore Court Hotel by phoning 057-934-6666.
Discover the rainbow. Taste the rainbow.
Tim and Tom live life on the go, which is fine when they're on form, but when heartburn or indigestion strikes, it can throw them off track. Gaviscon Double Action Tablets get to work instantly and last up to 2 times longer than antacids. For long-lasting relief on the go, Gaviscon Double Action Tablets.
He never believed in fairy tales. Knights in shining armor or happily ever after. But you believed when the right one came along, you'd be ready. Time to shine. Excellent.
Ireland's Country is brought to you by enjoytravel.co.uk. Music and dancing holidays.
Welcome back to the final part of Ireland's Country. And don't forget, of course, at our concert on the 3rd of April at the Tullamore Court Hotel. One of the young ladies who lives locally there will be appearing. Her name is Olivia Douglas.
Yes, indeed. She's a great singer, got a great future ahead of her. And here's a song from Olivia's one called Another Heartache here on Ireland's Country.
I should have known better. I had seen her time before. Rolling like a tumbleweed, the Texas wind has rolled. And I feel another heartache coming on. There's no doubt about it, darling, losing her to time. Like all those other memories branded on my mind. And I feel another heartache coming on. It's a shame you couldn't keep those promises you made to me, telling me you'd never do me wrong. Another lesson I've learned, not the friends that I will burn. It's just another heartache coming on. I guess I learned the hard way, darling, what was trying to turn. There's no sense in crying if it only makes it worse. We'll go on our separate ways and I'll be fine alone. Until I feel another heartache coming on.
Well, James, this building behind us, I'm sure in its heyday, was a very impressive structure. What is this building here?
This is the Dominican Priory here, which was founded in 1269 by Walter de Burgo.
Right.
With such a building like this, it shows that Lorrha would have had maybe a place of high population, or we had a lot of people came on pilgrimage here.
Yes.
All we see here today now is just the abbey itself, but there would have been a lot more buildings here. There would have been infirmaries, there would have been scriptoriums,
wow.
There would have been a big complex that would have encompassed all this area around us here.
So there could be hundreds of people
based here. Yeah. There's actually reference to Lorrha being a city one time, believe it or not.
Are you serious?
Yeah. So obviously it was during these monastic times that the population of Lorrha would have been very substantial or whatever. Or as I said, there could be a lot of pilgrimages here to Lorrha.
Yeah. I know you have a historical society here and there's a lot of work and research gone into it. And can people contact you on Facebook or...?
Yeah, they can contact us on Facebook. We set up there in 2010, myself and David Broderick, set up the Historical Society. So
yes.
We're doing a lot of research and work at the moment. We can be followed on Facebook and we'll have a website up and running shortly.
Yeah, we'll put the reference on the screen for our viewers at home.
Yeah,
so we can spend an entire show with you.
Yeah.
And James, listen, thanks very much indeed for your time on the programme.
Thanks, Brendan. Thanks
very
much.
Continued success.
Thanks, Brendan.
Next up on the programme, here's the latest release from Lisa McHugh. It's one called Play Me the Waltz of the Angels here on Ireland's Country.
Made a party last night for small folks. They were dancing and smiling. at me. Set this old man alone at a table, as if there's some place that he'd rather be. So I said, sir, can I play something for you? Something special that you'd like to hear. When he looked up at me, he was smiling. Oh, but his eyes couldn't hide the tears. He said, play me the waltz of the angels, and I'll close my eyes and pretend. Play me the waltz of the angels, so I can dance with my angel again. He said, yes, that's a song I remember. That's the one that she loved the best. It was playing the night that I met her, and it was playing when we laid her to rest. Play me the waltz of the angels, and I'll close my eyes and pretend. Play me the waltz of the angels, so I can dance with my angel again. Play me the waltz of the angels, and I'll close my eyes and pretend. Play me so I can dance with my angel again. Let me dance with my angel again.
Lisa McHugh, her latest one called Play Me the Waltz of the Angels. I'd like to say a big thank you to James Heelan, the local historian, for helping us and making today's programme.
A very interesting programme today. I might have a look around County Tipperary. Well, that's it for this week. We're back again next week with more great country music. Hopefully, join us then.